I'm Shelly. I'm going to take us through like a 15-minute vinyasa flow. I see that you are all still working really hard at home through Instagram stories, so I figured you could use a good stretch. We'll do a little flow, one movement to one breath, and then finish with a few stretches. I'm super awkward in real life, so I'm really even more awkward on camera, so bear with me. Go ahead and bring your eyes to a close. We'll take a seat, place your hands on your knees, and let the shoulder blades roll down on your back. Take a nice big inhale through the nose, and just let it go. Big inhale through the nose, fill up the belly, fill up the lungs. Let it go. Inhale, lift those arms overhead. Let that right hand come down towards the mat next to your hip and lean towards the right side, lengthening through that side body. Let your inhale bring you back up through center, leaning in the other direction. Nice gentle lean towards the left side, expanding through the ribcage on the right. Inhale, come back through center. As you exhale, take the left hand place on the right knee. Right hand comes behind you like a kickstand. So lift your chest tall, lengthening through the spine, pulling the crown of the head towards the ceiling. Inhale comes back through center. Exhale, twist the other direction. Lifting that chest nice and tall, feeling a nice spinal rotation. Take one more inhale here. And as we exhale, come back through center, bringing those heels as close to your butt as possible, or swinging your legs around, coming into tabletop position. Knees come underneath your hips, hands are directly underneath the shoulders. We'll take a big inhale, lifting the crown of the head up towards the ceiling, rounding the spine. Exhale, round the spine towards the ceiling, separating those shoulder blades apart, pushing the heels and the hands into the mat. Inhale for cow, expanding through the chest in front, and as you exhale, round that spine. Pull the belly button into the spine, feeling the shoulder blades separate, and take two more cat-cows at your own breath. And after you finish those two breaths, come back to neutral spine. Curl the toes behind you. Lift the knees off the mat and then send the hips back for downward facing dog. For your first run of the day, you can just wiggle out to get some movement, lengthening out the back of your legs. You can bend your knees here. Try to send your chest towards your thighs. Your knees can be as bent as you need them to be. Your heels don't have to touch the ground or anything. Just feel a nice lengthening through the spine. Your chest opens in front, pressing into all 10 fingertips. Take a big inhale, look towards your hands, bend your knees, and just walk all the way to the top of your mat for forward fold. Here we let our upper body hang as heavy as possible. Maybe you even take your gaze towards your belly button to feel the length in the back of your spine. Allow your knees to bend as much as you need to, it doesn't matter. There's no prize for straight legs here. Inhale, halfway lift, bringing your hands to your shins or your thighs. But the goal here is to lengthen the back, round the shoulder blades back for a nice flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reach up, rise up, get as tall as you can. Energy through the fingertips, and exhale, hands to heart center, bow forward. We'll do that again. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reach up, rise up. Exhale, let it go. One more time, adding a little heat. We inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reach up, rise up. And again, exhale, bow forward. Plant your hands right in front of your feet. Step back, meet yourself in plank, and then push to downward dog. Take a big inhale here. Exhale, let it go. Inhale your right heel towards the sky, letting those toes face the mat, keeping your hips square to the floor. You might feel your left heel get really heavy. Take another big inhale. And as we exhale, we lean forward into a plank and pull your knee into your nose, cheetah pose, pulling the belly button into the spine. Inhale, lengthen through the leg. Exhale, pull that knee towards the nose. Inhale. Exhale, pull it in one last time, feeling the lengthening through the back of the shoulder blades. And then send that foot all the way between your hands. Inhale, lift the chest up a little bit, catching your breath. Exhale, let that knee fall back towards the mat. Inhale, sweep the arms up. As you exhale, bring both hands onto the knee. Give yourself a little gentle push into that knee, feeling the length through that left hip flexor. Begin to slowly adjust the left hip forward just slightly as you push the knee forward at the same time. So it's almost like you're pulling that left hip and pushing that right knee, lengthening through that left hip flexor. Give it one more breath, big inhale. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, both arms to the ceiling. And then exhale, the left hand comes next to the right foot, plants nice firmly, and then lift the back knee off the mat, opening up the thoracic spine, right arm towards the ceiling, opening and expanding through the chest. As you exhale, send that hand back to the mat, step forward, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, reach up, rise up. Exhale, hands to heart center, bow forward. Plant the hands to the mat, step back, and find your way to downward dog. Take a big inhale here. Exhale, let it go. Let's do the other side. Inhale that left leg towards the ceiling. Again, hips stay square to the floor. Push that back heel through the back of the room, and let that right heel kind of fall heavy. Take another big inhale. As you exhale, lean forward into plank as you pull the knee towards your nose. Pull the belly button into the spine, strengthening through the core. Inhale, rise. Exhale, back to cheetah pose. One more time, inhale, lift. Exhale, knee to nose. Push those shoulder blades through the ceiling. And then use your core to send the foot all the way forward between the hands. Exhale, lower that back knee towards the floor. And inhale, lift that chest. Go. Inhale those arms to the ceiling, leaning, a gentle lean forward as you place the hands on the knees. Push that knee forward just gently, and at the same time that you do that, try to shift the right hip towards the front of the mat. So you feel lengthening in that right hip flexor this time. Take another breath here. Let it go. Inhale both those arms to the ceiling. Exhale, right hand to the left foot. And lift that back knee off of the mat, opening and expanding through the chest, feeling those shoulder blades squeeze behind you. And enjoy just one more breath here. As you exhale, step forward into forward fold. This time we inhale, sweep the arms up, send the hips back for chair pose. Almost like a squat, but really try to lift that chest towards lifting the chest up, almost as if you're trying to lean the back against a wall. Arms can be up, or forward, or here, it doesn't matter. And take a breath. Take another big inhale, and forward fold. Let it go. Again, hang heavy here, maybe shake it out. Loosen up a little, hopefully you have enough heat in the body. We send our feet back for plank, and then downward dog. Moving through a little bit more of a flow, we inhale the right leg to the ceiling. And as we exhale, we bring it through for warrior two. So foot comes between both hands. We seal the back edge of the foot to match the edge of our mat. And then we relax. Bending deep through the front knee. That knee is in line with our middle toe. Let the shoulder blades relax. Flip the front palm. As we inhale, we lift our arm towards the ceiling as high as we can. And then reverse and lean back just slightly. Back arm can rest on the back thigh or wrap around the waist, but feeling a nice big side body stretch. As we exhale, we bring the elbow to the knee for side angle. Arm can reach towards the ceiling or overhead by the ear. It's still expanding through the chest. Maybe feeling a stretch to the inner thigh in the front. And as you inhale again, move back to reverse warrior. And then exhale. Come forward. Step back, downward dog. Take a big inhale here. And let it go. Inhale the left leg to the ceiling. And as you exhale, pull it through for warrior two on the other side. Front heel is in line with the back arch, so we're nice and stable. Relax the shoulder blades from the ears. Inhale, flip the front palm, lift towards the tall. As we exhale, we bring our elbow to our knee and extend that top arm over to the ceiling or over towards our ear. Again, lengthening through that side body. And as we inhale again, we reverse warrior. This time, exhale. Cartwheel the hands back to the front of the mat. Step back and downward dog. Take another breath here. Exhale, let it go. One more time, big inhale. Let it go. Look towards the top of your mat. Bend your knees and inhale, step forward or hop forward into forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, reach up, rise up, look up. Exhale, hands come to heart center. Okay, let's move through a little balance flow. Since you're at home, if you fall over, who cares? So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna mirror what you're doing. Shift all of your weight into your right foot. Inhale those arms to the sky. And let your left knee come up with you. So that knee stops at hip level. And you can stay right here if this feels good. Or extend that leg straightened, bracing through the quad, flexing those toes towards you. Take a big inhale. Exhale, hands come to heart center. Ankle crosses over the knee, sink back for figure four. A nice good stretch in that glute and hip. Again, we inhale, lift up for standing staff. Keep the knee bent or the leg straight, your choice. Exhale, figure four. Again, inhale, we rise. Exhale, come down. Sinking the hips back. We take one more. Inhale, lift. This time, exhale, send that leg behind you for a long lunge. Chest is tall. Very good. And bring your arms to heart center. We're gonna move into lizard pose. This is a really good hip opener. This one's for my man Jeff out there. I know he loves some lizard. So all we're gonna do is we're gonna lower our back knee towards the floor. Send that back leg as far as you can behind you, almost like you're straightening the leg behind you. And then place both hands inside of your foot. And you can stay right here if this feels good. Or you can grab a block or whatever you have at home, a stack of books, something to rest your elbows on to get closer to the earth. Or my personal favorite, you can send that knee away from you, lifting the arch of the foot off the mat. Or you can use your hand to push the knee away, like you're disgusted with your knee, you don't even wanna look at it, just push it away, creating space for those hips and hip flexor to feel open. Whichever option you chose, we will hold here for a few uncomfortable breaths. Make sure that back leg is long behind you so you really can create space. Three breaths remain here. And let's come back to center, placing those hands to frame the foot. Send that front foot behind you and come back to downward dog. Take a big inhale. Let it go. Look towards the front of your mat, bend your knees, and as you inhale, step or hop to the top of your mat. Again, hanging in that forward fold. We inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reach up, rise up, all the way up, and exhale, hands to heart center. Let's do the other side. So we'll shift all of our weight into our left foot this time, still staying tall, and that as we inhale those arms up, the right knee comes with us. It stops right at hip level. You can stay here if this feels good, or if you want, you can straighten that leg for a little bit more of a challenge. Keep embracing that quad, and then pull that those toes towards your face. Take a big inhale. Exhale, bring that knee or that ankle over the knee for a figure four stretch, pushing the hips back almost like you're sitting into a squat. Inhale, rise. Exhale, lower. One more time, we inhale, rise. Bouncing through that core. Exhale, figure four. Take one more inhale. And this time as you exhale, send that leg far behind you. I'll turn so you can see from the side this time. Big crescent lunge. Bending that back knee ever so slightly. Exhale, bring the hands to heart center. And then we'll slowly lower that knee towards the mat. Again, we walk that knee as far back as it will go, comfortably. So we feel length of that hip flexor already. And then when you're ready, you'll place the hands in the inside of your foot. And you can stay here if this feels great. You can let that arch of the foot lift off from here, or you can assist it with your hand opening up, pushing away. And again, we'll hold here for a few uncomfortable breaths. Hopefully you feel those hips and glutes opening just a little. Two breaths remain here. Bring that knee back in towards your chest, frame that front foot, curl the back toe. This time step forward, forward fold. We'll move through my favorite IT band stretch. So in your forward fold, let your upper body hang heavy. You might need to bring a prop here if the floor feels really far away from you. But go ahead and bend your right knee. As you bend your right knee, straighten the left. Plant the right hand right in front of the front foot, in front of the right foot, and then open your left arm, open your chest. Again, if the ground is too far because you're not 5'2 like me, you can lift your arm up onto a block or a book or something, and you should feel length through this left IT band. Opening up that chest, that arm can stay tall, or you can wrap it around the waist and open the chest that way. Let's hold for one more breath. Let it go. Let's come back down to center, shake it out. And we'll take it to the other side. Bend the left knee, straighten that right knee. Left hand plants right in front of the left foot. Right arm opens up the other direction. Again, the arm can stay tall, or you can wrap it around that waist and opening up the chest a little further. Take one more breath here. Exhale, let it go. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, reach up, rise up all the way. As you exhale, bring the hands to heart center. And then bow forward. Plant the hands to the mat, step or hop into your high plank, and then press back to downward dog. We'll just take one more breath here. As you exhale, bring yourself into tabletop position. Hands will come right underneath shoulders, knees underneath hips. We'll move into puppy pose to really open up the chest and shoulders. So keep your hips directly over your knees the whole time, and then you're just gonna walk yourself forward. And then just let your chest melt into the mat. You can find a comfortable place for your face. Maybe it's your forehead or a cheek, or your chin can rest on the mat. We'll hold here for three breaths. After that third breath, allow yourself to walk back into tabletop, curl the back toes, push the hips back to the ceiling. We'll take one more hip stretch. Inhale, lift the right leg to the sky, and as you exhale, pull it through for pigeon pose. Right knee comes towards the right wrist, left leg, it continues to straighten behind you, just like we did for lizard, that leg goes long. You wanna keep your shin close to being parallel to the top of the mat. It's not gonna happen overnight, I'm still not there. But you just wanna make sure the further away it is from your knee, the more stretch you'll get. Try to keep both cheeks off of the mat. Maybe you place a prop or a blanket underneath your glute to keep your hips lifted. You can stay tall right here if this feels good enough. Or you can take it to your elbows. Or you can just melt into the mat and stay right here. If this pose is uncomfortable or it kind of tweaks your knee, you could flip over onto your back and give yourself a figure four stretch, crossing the ankle over the knee. Two breaths remain here. Allow that next inhale to bring you back onto your palms. Curl the back toes, and then swing that right leg behind you for downward dog. Maybe you pedal up the heels, maybe you shake side to side, do what feels good to shake out that leg. And then we inhale the left leg to the sky. As you exhale, pull that left knee towards the left wrist. Again, straightening that right leg behind you, lifting the chest tall. You can stay here, or you can melt onto the elbows or onto your chest. Try to make sure you're flexing those left toes towards your left knee. That will deepen the stretch a little bit. And then try to let go right here. Let go of whatever tension you're holding on to. Let those hips feel gravity doing the work. Two breaths remain here. Let that next inhale bring you back up onto your palms. Bring that left leg back for downward dog. Shake it out, do what feels good. And then let your knees come to the mat. And then we're gonna swing around to a seated position, letting our feet come in front of us. You can keep your feet planted on the floor, or you can lift your feet off the floor so shins are parallel to the mat. You can reach forward, or you can bring your hands behind your thighs, your choice. And we're just gonna hold, boat pose. And if you're bored, I have more. Take a big inhale here. Exhale, let it go. Again, you can stay right here or come with me. Inhale, lower down to canoe, kind of like a hollow body hold. Feeling everything turn on, keeping shoulder blades up, feet up. Inhale, exhale, boat pose. Inhale back to canoe. Exhale back to boat. Inhale down. Exhale up. One more time. Inhale to canoe. Hold, hold, hold. Exhale back to boat. Hold for one more breath. Maybe you lift your feet to straighten all the way up. And then exhale, let the feet come down, and then let your upper body come down. Very good. Pull the right knee into your chest. Give it a big inhale as you pull that knee into the chest. Give it a squeeze. And as you exhale, we'll take a spinal twist, letting that right leg come to the left side of the body. That right arm expands into like a big T. Let that right shoulder blade fall heavy towards the floor. And just relax. Maybe your gaze is towards the ceiling, or maybe it's to the right side. Whatever's comfortable here. We'll hold for two breaths. Inhale, bring that knee back into the chest. Give it a little squeeze, and then say goodbye to the right leg. Inhale, pull the left knee into the chest. Give it a nice squeeze again. Give it a hug. And then as you exhale, spinal twist. Push that right knee towards the floor on the right side. You can just gently let gravity do the work, not forcing the knee too far. You can assist it with that hand. And then make sure that left shoulder blade stays anchored into the ground. We'll hold for two more breaths. Hug both knees into the chest this time. Squeezing the knees in. Maybe you rock side to side to release that low back. Or maybe you pull up into a small, small ball. Curling in, squeezing everything. And then as you exhale, let it go. Just flop like a starfish onto your mat. Let your eyes close gently for just a moment. Feel every muscle relax into the mat. And allow yourself for just a few moments to do nothing. Just pretend you have nowhere to go after this, because you probably don't, because we're stuck at home during the pandemic. So relax and just enjoy doing nothing. Take 3 breaths to yourself. Allow your next inhale, bend your knees, bring your hands behind your thighs, and however long it takes, just kind of rock yourself forward and backwards. Whenever you're ready, roll yourself all the way up, back to seated, crossing those legs in front. Maybe you blink open those eyes, maybe you don't. Take a big inhale, lift those arms overhead.